Hello everyone, welcome to Create Don't Hate YouTube Hub. Kanika Jain this side from Handmade by Kanika, and I welcome you all in this video. So if you are new to my channel, then do hit the subscribe button and turn the bell notifications on. And today in this video, I shall be making this shadow box. Make sure to watch the full video as one of the lucky winners will receive this shadow box from my side. So let's get started. So to make the base of the shadow box here, I have my 12x12 cardstock in the shade pastel blue, and I am scoring first at 1 inch. Next we are going to score at 1.5 inches, so the final size of the shadow box will be 6 inches. The next we are going to score at 2.5 inches, and then after we are going to score at 3 inches. So in all we have made 4 scoring lines. So similarly we will repeat this step on all the other 3 remaining sides as well. That is, we are going to score at 1 inches, 1.5 inches, then 2.5 inches, and then 3 inches. So this one is going to be the 6 inch shadow box. If you want to know how to make an 8 inch shadow box, you can check out the description, as the link to that is in description box, or refer to my video number 59 as I have updated the tutorial already. Now I am done scoring on all the 4 sides. Now what I am going to do is on 4 inch mark, that is here, I will be making an mark till 1.5 inches, till the second line, that's the horizontal line, like this. Similarly on 8 inch, that is 1 inch before the 9 inches, I'm going to make 1.5 inch mark like this, and then rotating my paper to 180 degrees, I will repeat the same process. So you need to make sure that you make these lines on the opposite sides and up till the 1.5 inch mark. Now I need to make this diagonal line from here to the line which I have made just now, like this, and similarly on this side as well, and on the opposite sides as well. So this is very quick and easy way to make your own shadow box frames. If you want to see more such kind of tutorials, make sure you subscribe to our channel and like this video. And to participate in the giveaway, make sure you comment down below and you as well mention the country you belong to. So now I'm marking the areas which I need to trim using my pair of scissors. So you need to make sure you're following this step, and you need to trim off on the pencil marks. If you want to buy any of these craft supplies, you can check out the description box for the links. So this hop will be running till 30th May 2020, and make sure you participate in the giveaway and use proper hashtags and cheer on social media, and for more details you can check out the description box as well. Now I'm done with trimming off the side. So this is how my shadow box now looks like. So now with the help of my bone folder, I'm just creasing the line so that I get very crisp folds, and it is a very essential step if you want to get nice and crisp folds. So now for the next step, what I'm going to do is I'm going to trim off this from one side so that these becomes the fold and they can easily fold in and give a proper balance to my shadow box frame. Like here, you can see how this looks now. As well, later on I made these slant cuts so that they easily slide in, and now comes the part that I need to adhere. So on all the four outer sides, which is the 1 inch side, I am adding adhesive. So here I am using 12mm tacky tape and I am applying 2 layers of them. You can as well use 1 layer of 24mm red tacky tape, or as well you can use your any of the liquid adhesives, it's as per you. Now, as I have used red tacky tape, it's very important to burnish them. So with the help of my bone folder, I'm doing that. So now I'll start adhering these to the base. So first of all, I'm adhering the both of these sides, opposite sides, the rectangular ones. I'm just removing the backing. So here you can see I'm using the ultimate die cleaning tool and I'm using the needle tip. So if you want to know more about that tool, you can check out the description box as the video link is already mentioned. As the next opposite sides will be coming diagonally, so what I'm going to do is like this. Can you see the diagonal lines? So onto that area I will be using my liquid adhesive so that it makes sure that my base of the shadow box is sturdy. Likewise, our base of the shadow box is now ready, and now we have to just embellish it. So for that, what I'm going to do is here I'm taking the Dress My Craft Magnolias paper pad, and I have this sheet, so I will be trimming off this paper to the size 4x4 inches. So here, using my gelatin trimmer, I'm just trimming off the paper to the size 4x4, cutting out a square so which fits in exactly at the center. So this size fits in perfectly. So on the back side I'm applying red tacky tape. This one is the 6mm. You can use any size of the red tacky tape, or as well use liquid adhesive, or as well if you want to give dimension to the base, you can use 3D foam tape as well. I just need to embellish it. So here I have this sentiment which says "Hello my friend," which I will be using as a focal point, and I want to give it a little bit of dimension. So here I'm using my 3D foam tape, and as you all know, whenever I use 3D foam tape, I make sure that I apply liquid adhesive to make sure that it sticks permanently on the base, and then at the center I'm adding it. Now here I have used some of my foliage dies and have done die cutting onto a similar color cardstock of the base, which I will be adding like this. And here I have my daisy flower which I will be adding, and then to add more dimension here I have these pollens, and then on the other side as well I will add pollen flower and small size of these foliage, so it looks very much complete. And now I will be sticking them using my hot glue gun. And tada, our shadow box frame is ready. I hope you enjoyed this video. Do hop on to the other channels as well. The link of all those channels are in description box. Get inspired and thanks for watching. Hope to see you soon.